Hello everyone, I have something special for you, I believe I have. I was recently in Germany playing a clavichord concert for a very nice private organization. The day after I gave a lecture on tempo, maybe more on that later in another video. But the clavichord concert was on Friday evening in a beautiful location. It was a location that sounded quiet, with a lot of reverb, I would say. You will hear that on the recording. And I tested this new camera out, which I have since a few months, but I've never been able to take it on location, really. With this microphone that's actually suited perfectly for speech, not so much for recording an instrument, but I regularly come in occasions where, well, this camera could be used just to capture the moment, not to be, you know, to have the ambition to capture a great recording in the sense of sound recording. But you'll see that some settings were not right, and so the camera focused perfectly the first 3 seconds of the concert and actually also the last 50 seconds. For the rest of the video, you will see that it focuses on the lady that's in front of the camera, for which I cannot blame this camera for. But it was not what he was supposed to do. He should have focused on me. But you see me playing, and the sound is what it is. With this microphone, I'm actually pretty impressed. In that room, which was so reverberant, that you couldn't actually speak to people who were 2 meters in, away from you. This clavichord, I adapted in the room, and the clavichord sounded like, well, a big instrument. I've played a concert with a program which you find in the description box, which was a little bit experimental in the sense that I start with Bach, I end with Bach, and I play Bach in the middle of the program, which is of on its own not so experimental. But it is when you know that in between those 3 Bach moments, Wohltemperierte Klavier Book 1, I played a Mozart sonata and a Beethoven sonata. And so after the last movement of a Beethoven sonata, I played the Opus 10 number 2, so the F major, which is a pretty happy ending, so to say, as it's kind of, a full orchestral sound for the clavichord or the piano, if you wish. And then to play a Bach piece after that was an experiment, but it felt a little awkward when I started the F major prelude and fugue, but it also felt very much like coming home. The unity, the concert had a kind of unity, was a very, very nice atmosphere. I played an hour with an audience that just was there with me. And that's, of course, the beauty of the clavichord. It's also maybe due to the tempo that I took. I don't know. I don't want to make this into a tempo question video or whatever. But all of this Friday evening, it was just wonderful. And I'm really happy that I can share that concert with you, in spite of the fact that I'm a little bit blurry out of focus. But maybe that enhances the listening experience. Who knows? And as I mentioned before, the day after I gave a lecture all about tempo, a lecture of 2 hours with a break and then 30, 40 minutes perhaps in questions and answers. Also, that was recorded with this camera. Also, another challenge that we met with sound. But I will see in the future if I can share parts or maybe entire lecture that I gave there with you here. Anyways, for now, I'm happy to share this clavichord concert with you. It was, as I said, a very nice experience. I was very focused on the music, thanks to the instruments, thanks to the room, and especially thanks to the audience that was there. And you'll not see a lot of them. There were like 20 or 25 people, of course, in the entire room with COVID restrictions. But there you have it. And so without further ado, I hope you enjoy this clavichord concert with music by Bach, Mozart, and Haydn. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.